just the Chromebook and the headphones. Good job. You can close your Chromebook and put it over here in the bucket. You can close it. There you go. Perfect. So. Okay. And then, Josiana, when it's your turn to go, same thing. There's a bucket over there with your name on it. Chromebook headphones go in it, and you'll drop out for math. Thank you. That's all I have. You too. All right. So, I said a while ago, a little sidetracked. There on the left, that bear looks really chubby. If it's a drought year, is the bear going to get chubby? Probably not. He's probably going to be a little skinny. He's going to look a little skinny and scrawny. And if he's that way, is he going to be able to protect himself and his family? Probably not as well. Genesis? Oh my, that was very brave of them. Alright, so if black bears do not have as much food as usual, they... I don't know, I'm going to say they will be skinny. And might not survive. There we go. What did you write? Anything different, David? Aren't black bears what? The weakest bear. I have that. I don't know. I don't know too much about bears. Hang out with bears. Might be. There's lots of different kinds of bears out there. So it might be. Yes, Ella. Did you? Well, you are in its neighborhood. And that's what we're going to talk about right now is those of you who have seen bears while you're camping because you're in its neighborhood, let's go ahead and turn the page. And here we have a bear going through trash to find food because the food is not available in their natural habitat. So environmental changes can have an impact as to how bears find food. All right. Ella? Let it dry and burn it in a fireplace, use as fuel, like the homesteaders did with the buffalo chips. Okay, see how things have changed? And big bears up in the mountains where the bears live, it gets snow, it's cold there. But she doesn't need to use her fireplace because she has a heater. Things have definitely changed.